friends, in this video we will discuss projectile motion up on an inclined plane. Please make sure you watch projectile motion part 1 to part 7, then go ahead with part 8. Suppose we have an inclined plane which is inclined at an angle theta, and then suppose a ball or a projectile is thrown up from the bottom of the incline with initial speed u at an angle alpha from the incline. So this particle will go up to some height and then comes down and land here, making a curved path. Suppose particle is here, then its velocity vector would be along the tangent of the path like this. And gravity is acting all the time on the ball and it's downward, so gravitational acceleration vector would be like this. Now we have to set a frame of reference. So if you remember, when particle is thrown on the ground like this, then we take initial point as the origin and x-axis along the ground and y-axis perpendicular to the ground. The same way here, particle is projected on an inclined plane, so we will take initial point as a origin like here and along the incline like this. This is our x-axis and perpendicular to the incline would be the y-axis. For convenience, you can rotate page so you better understand x and y components of velocity and acceleration vector. So here initial velocity is u, its horizontal component would be ux and vertical component would be uy. Ux equals u cos alpha and uy equals u sin alpha. The same way we have to split the gravitational acceleration vector. So you know, gravity is acting downward like this. So along the incline would be this component, it would be gx, and perpendicular to the incline, this would be the gy. So if you see this right angle triangle, this angle is theta, this angle is 90 degree, so this angle is 90 minus theta. So as you can see, this whole thing is 90, so this angle would be theta. And the rule of components is, like this is g and this one perpendicular is gy and this one is the gx, and our theta is this angle here. So the component along the theta would be cos and the other component would be the sine. So gy would be the g cos theta because it's along angle theta, and the other component is gx, it would be g sin theta. Let's make table for x and y components. We have ux and uy. So ax is the acceleration in the horizontal direction, which is gx. You can see gx in the opposite direction of x-axis, so it will be minus gx. So ax would be minus gx and gx is minus g sin theta. And ay would be gy. Acceleration in vertical direction is gy and it's in opposite direction of positive y-axis, so it's actually minus gy. And we found gy equals to g cos theta, so minus g cos theta. Now we have to find the maximum height from inclined plane. Maximum height from the incline is this when projectile is at the top of its path. This is height maximum. For maximum height, we always use the concept that at the maximum height, vertical component of velocity goes to zero. So Vy equals to zero at maximum height. We are going to use this third equation of kinematics. We will write this equation in the vertical components. Vy to the whole square, Vy to the whole square plus 2a delta y. Delta y is the vertical displacement, and at the top, vertical displacement is actually the height maximum. So we are finding here delta y. Plug in all the values. Vy is 0. Vy is the initial vertical component, which is uy, that means u sin alpha, plus 2. Ay is minus g cos theta delta y. Now solve this to find delta y. It will give us u square sin square alpha minus 2g cos theta delta y. Taking this term to here, it will become 2g cos theta delta y equals u square sin square alpha. So we will get delta y equals u square sin square alpha divided by 2g cos theta. Delta y is the height maximum. So this is the formula of maximum height on an inclined plane. You can use this direct formula to solve any problem, but I will suggest you to always use kinematic equation to solve for maximum height, because this way you don't need to memorize this complicated formula. And also, kinematic equations are applicable to all kind of projectile motions. Next, we are going to find time of the flight. Time of the flight is the total time taken by particle from initial point to the final point. We always use displacement equation to find the time of the flight. This is initial point and this is final point. You can see vertical position of initial point and final point. Both are zero because particle returns to its initial height. Y1 is the vertical position of initial point, which is 0, and y2 is the vertical position of final point, which is also 0 because both are at the incline. So delta y, which is change in vertical displacement, y2 minus y1 is 0. So we are going to use this displacement equation. Delta y equals v0 y t plus half a t square. Delta y equals 0. From initial point to final point, there is no vertical displacement, and VOY is actually the initial vertical velocity, which is u sin alpha. AY is minus g cos theta. Now we have to solve it to find time t, taking this term to left. 1t cancelled out. So t equals 2u sin alpha over g cos theta. This is formula of time of flight of the particle on an inclined plane. In problems, you will be given u, alpha and theta. You just need to plug in values here and solve for the time of the flight. You can also use this kinematic equation to solve for the time of flight, which is much easier. Next is we have to find the range of the particle. Range is the maximum horizontal displacement. That means horizontal distance from initial point to the final point. This is initial point and here is the final point. So this would be the range from here to here. As range is maximum horizontal displacement, so we will use the formula of displacement here, which is delta x equals, we will use all the horizontal components. Vux is u cos alpha times t plus ax is minus g sin theta times t square. So we got equation of range u cos alpha time. This t is the total time, which is the time of the flight. So here we will put capital T as the symbol of time of flight, minus half g sin theta t square. So this is the equation of range of the projectile on an inclined plane. In the problems, you will be given values u, alpha and theta. Using them, first you have to find the time of the flight and then use displacement equation and solve for the range. I hope you understand the concept of the topic here. In the following video, we will discuss projectile motion down the inclined plane. So stay tuned and study more. Don't forget to subscribe, share and like for daily updates. Thank you.